Okay, sister, most welcome. Your name and your profession and your question.
Ya, terima kasih atas kesempatannya. Saya adalah seorang Katolik. Pertanyaan yang akan saya tanyakan adalah, jika seorang ibu menolak dan memutus hubungan dengan seorang anak karena ia menjadi seorang Muslim, apakah dibenarkan jika akhirnya anak tersebut menjauh dari ibunya? Bagaimana Al-Quran menulis tentang hal ini? Terima kasih.
The sister said that she is a Catholic, and if a non-Muslim accepts Islam, and if the parents realize that she accepts Islam and they reject her, how should she behave? If a non-Muslim accepts Islam and the parents come to know and they reject her, how should she behave? She should behave much better to her parents than what she was before she accepted Islam. The moment a non-Muslim accepts Islam, he should or she should be better than what he or she was before they accepted Islam. Because Allah says in the Quran, in Surah Luqman, chapter number 31, verse number 14, and Surah Ankabut, chapter number 29, verse number 8, we have enjoined on the human beings to be good to their parents. It is compulsory that you should be good to your parents. And our beloved Prophet Muhammad Sallallahu Alaihi Wasallam said, that paradise lies beneath the feet of the mother. That means, even if your parents are non-Muslim, yet you have to love them, you have to respect them. Our beloved, the other person, it's mentioned in Sahih Bukhari, volume number 8, in the book of Adab, book of manners, chapter number 2, hadith number 2, a man approaches the Prophet and asks him, who deserves the maximum love and companionship? The Prophet said, your mother. The man asked after that too. The Prophet said, your mother. The man asked after that too. The Prophet said, your mother. The man asked after that too. The Prophet said, your father. That means 75%, 3/4 of the love and companionship goes to the mother, 1/4 goes to the father. In short, mother gets the gold medal, she gets the silver medal, as well as the bronze medal. The father has to be satisfied with a mere consolation prize. These are the teachings of Islam. Even if you become a Muslim and your parents are yet non-Muslim, yet, you have to respect your mother. You have to obey her. Only those things what your parents tell you, which are against the Quran and against the teaching of the Sahih Hadith of Muhammad Sallallahu Alaihi Wasallam, those are the only things you can refuse to follow. Because the same verse when it continues, Surah Luqman chapter 31 verse number 15 and Surah Ankabut chapter number 29 verse number 8 says that if your parents do jihad, strive and struggle to make you worship somebody else besides Allah, don't obey them. Yet, live with them with love and companionship. That means, once you accept Islam, you have to be a better child, better daughter, better son than what you were before. For example, your mother wanted you to wear blue and you hated blue color. The moment you accept Islam, now you start wearing blue, because wearing blue is not haram. Your mother would start thinking, my daughter never wore blue and now she's wearing blue because I like it. You have to tell, in Islam, I have to love you, I have to respect you, you have to take care of her more, see to it that you talk to her more kindly. If you're an adult, if she requires, give her more money, speak to her more kindly. There should be a difference. They should think, what has happened to my daughter? What has happened to my son? They have changed completely. They are so obedient, they listen to me. Only those things which are haram in Islam, which is against the Quran and the Sahih Hadith, only those things you don't obey. Everything else, you follow them, obey them, love them, sacrifice for them. They should notice a difference, that what has happened to my child, to my son, to my daughter. Then you say, this is Islam. We have to love our parents, we have to respect her, we have to take care of her. Hope that answers the question. Sister, have you read about Islam? Can you ask the question? Ask the sister. Brother. Yeah, we are not doing your job properly, brother. What happened?
Brother, according to the committee, our time is over.
Ah, fine, at least finish this.
Okay.
Do your job first.
Okay. It's okay. Yeah, please.
Why are you talking somewhere else? You can't do two things at the same time. You are a coordinator, mashallah. Ask the sister, has she read about Islam? Ask the sister. Brother, do you understand English? Ask the sister. Can somebody help him? Inna lillahi wa inna ilayhi raji'un.
Mbak yang barusan bertanya sudah bersyahadat? Apakah sudah bersyahadat atau belum?
Yeah, brother, I never asked that. What are you saying? What are you asking her?
Have you declared syahadat?
Did I say that? There's a problem. I don't know. Brother, I said, ask her, did she read about Islam? Where did I say, did you say the Shahada? Please, see to it that the coordinator is there on the stage.
Sorry, sir.
Please ask her, has she read about Islam?
Here, your name is Michelle. Is still confusing about which one the religion is, she will choose. And instead, her sister is mu'alaf now. But she is confusing how to convince her mom or her father to accept them as a child, but in the different religion, in Catholic.
I'm asking you to ask her,
yeah?
Does she have knowledge about Islam?
Apakah Anda
she wants to learn about Islam.
Does she believe that there is one God?
Apakah kamu percaya tentang adanya?
See, she's doing a very good job.
Yeah, she believes in one God.
Does she believe that Jesus is God or is he messenger of God?
She believes that Jesus is the messenger of God.
Mashallah. Does she believe that Prophet Muhammad is the messenger of God?
She believes that Muhammad is also the messenger of God.
Mashallah. That means she's a Muslim. To be a Muslim, tell her two things are required. To believe there is one God, to believe Jesus is a messenger of God, peace be upon him, and Prophet Muhammad is a messenger of God. So she believes, according to me, she is a Muslim.
She doesn't brave to declare because her sister accept a
different religion.
No. Her sister is a Muslim now, and her mother is angry with her. And her sister doesn't want the younger sister will be accepted in the same way.
Ask her who is greater, God or mother? Her mother is greater or God is greater?
God.
So, if your God gets angry, aren't you scared of your God? If your God gets angry,
I'm afraid of God.
Okay. Now, who should she love more? God more or the mother more?
It's God.
Correct. Who should she be afraid of displeasing? First God or mother?
God.
Correct. So first priority is God. Mother is important, very important. She should love her. But displeasing the God is more bad than displeasing the mother. So if she has a choice between the two, she should first follow God and then try and please the mother later on.
She thinks that in Islam, mother is number one.
Yes, number one among the human being, but not above Allah and His Rasul, not above God and the Messenger. Among the human being, yes, I agree with you.
I believe God is number one, but in Islam, kita diajarkan untuk menghormati ibu. Saya menjauh dari ibu saya bukan karena saya tidak sayang
bukan karena saya tidak ingin berbakti, tapi saat saya dekat, justru saya ingin dipisahkan dengan keluarga saya, karena saya tidak sama dengan dia. Sekarang permasalahannya adalah adik saya kebingungan. Kalau saya mungkin sudah punya penghasilan, meskipun saya masih bersusah payah untuk menghidupi keluarga saya. Sedangkan adik saya ini posisinya masih sekolah. Kalau misalkan dengan istilahnya dia mengucapkan syahadat dan menjadi muslim, lalu dia dibuang dari keluarga, apa yang harus saya lakukan? Itu. Terus kalau saya sementara menjauh karena kondisi ibu saya masih belum bisa menerima, saya hanya bisa berusaha untuk mendoakan saja.
And the sisters, what I understand from the translation, the sister said that she is afraid that the mother will get angry because the sister accepted Islam and she is angry. She is afraid that she will make the mother angry, therefore she is confused. Sister, I would like to ask you a question. Do you want your mother to go to Jannah or not? Do you want your mother to go to paradise or not?
Yes.
So if you want her to go to paradise, if you don't accept Islam, and if you don't tell her, then how will she go to paradise?
Saya merasa belum punya kemampuan untuk itu. Karena saya juga masih banyak yang saya tanyakan. Sehingga saya merasa tidak kompeten untuk mengajak ibu saya. Tapi dalam hati, jauh dalam hati kecil saya ingin suatu saat ibu saya juga hanya mengakui satu Tuhan.
The sister said that she feels she's unable to yet understand many things about Islam, so how she will tell the mother? Sister, even if you don't understand Islam correctly, at least you told now that you believe there is one God, you believe Jesus is not God but messenger of God, peace be upon him, you believe that Prophet Muhammad is the messenger of God. Only say this is sufficient, this is the minimum. You don't have to become a scholar or a sheikh. As long as you know you take out the shirk from your life, only by believing that Jesus, peace be upon him, is not God, is a messenger of God, itself is removing the shirk. If you can't understand, take my video cassette, Similarities Between Islam and Christianity. I'm sure the translation has been done in the Bhasha language. Give it to your mother. You don't have to open your mouth also. But it is important that you save yourself from hellfire first. After saving yourself, you have to save your mother. On the day of judgment, you will be responsible for your actions and deeds. Your mother will be responsible for her action and her deeds. If you understand, if you realize Allah is one, if you realize Jesus is the messenger of God and Prophet Muhammad is the messenger of God, peace be upon them. And if you did not tell your mother, on the day of judgment, your mother will ask you, if you knew, why didn't you tell me? And what reply will you give?
She tells that she wants to give some videos about yours to her mom.
Good. She should give my videos to her mom, but she should save herself also. If she realizes that there's one God and Muhammad sallallahu alaihi wasallam is the messenger, she should accept it. That will save her from the hellfire. Ask her, does she know how long will she live?
I don't know.
Don't know. What if you go out of this university and if a car comes and you have an accident, what will happen? If you go out and if you have an accident and you die and God will ask you, why didn't you accept Islam? What will you reply? You heard the lecture of Dr. Zakir Naik. You understood, you agreed, but didn't accept. Who's to blame? You or me?
Of course, me.
So what reply will you have then? What reply will she have? That if something happens tomorrow, she dies and she does not accept Islam, then who will be responsible?
My sister.
So that's what I'm asking you, sister, that if she agrees that there is one God and Prophet Muhammad is the messenger, why isn't she accepting it? I request the organizers, Mr. Bukhari, next time, see to it that you have a good translator on the stage. You know, you are losing. We Muslims are to blame. Allah will ask you on the day of judgment, when Dr. Zakir Naik came to Indonesia, why didn't you keep a good translator on the stage? What will you reply? There are many people who want to love Islam, who want to learn Islam. Only by seeing my video cassette, they accept Islam. I come to Indonesia and you don't have a good translator on the stage. Who's to blame? Zakir Naik. Keep someone who's fluent in English. Don't you have one person in the whole of Indonesia? You see the Christian missionaries, when they go, when they have their discourses in foreign languages, they're expert. They do the same modulation as the speaker, sentence by sentence. This is the stage of the Muslim Ummah today. We can't even translate to a non-Muslim about our deen. Yes, sister, I'm waiting for the answer. See how much time we are wasting.
Sorry, sir. Someone told me that Bapak translator, kalau bisa sehabis Bapak
Zakir Naik. Say in English.
Okay. Someone told me that as a translator, please after Dr. Zakir Naik said something, directly the translator translate in Indonesia. But not in the text. But I mean orally, so that we can understand all.
Stop aja, Mbak. Langsung ke pertanyaan. Saya yang terjemahin. I will.
Ah, Masya Allah.
Sorry, sir, it's not about the question, but the understanding.
Ayo, langsung aja pertanyaannya lagi ulang. Dr. Zakir tadi bertanya, kalau Anda tidak tahu kapan Anda meninggal, dan tiba-tiba nanti keluar dari ruangan ini, ada kecelakaan Anda meninggal dunia, bagaimana tentang diri Anda sendiri? Anda belum bersyahadat, belum masuk Islam. Apakah Anda siap untuk mempertanggungjawabkan tentang diri Anda, bukan tentang ibu Anda, di hadapan Allah Subhanahu wa Ta'ala? Langsung aja jawab pakai bahasa Indonesia. Gak usah diterjemahin lagi, Mbak. Mbak, gak usah dijelasin lagi. Langsung aja jawab yang bersangkutan. Panitia lain mundur. Langsung yang bersangkutan, tolong. Masih ada apa enggak?
Ya, saya merasa bersalah kalau saya tidak bisa membantu mereka.
Bukan tentang mereka, tentang diri Anda sendiri yang ditanya oleh Dr. Zakir.
Oh, maksudnya kalau Bapak adik saya.
Oh. Anda sudah Islam belum?
Alhamdulillah sudah.
Oke. Okay. She is Muslim, dokter. She is Muslim.
My elder sister is a Catholic.
There is mistake. She is Muslim already.
No, I know that. There is, I can understand that it is changing. One is a sister who's accepted Islam. The other sister, the younger sister, she's yet a Catholic. Both are coming one after the other on the microphone. The first lady who came, who asked the question, she was a Catholic. And she agreed that there is one Allah, and she agreed that Muhammad is the messenger. But she is getting scared to accept Islam because she doesn't want to hurt her sister. Correct?
Yeah.
So I am asking that sister who's a Catholic, that is it more important to please Allah or to please the mother? Who is more important?
Yeah, pertanyaannya apakah yang penting adalah mendapatkan ridho Allah atau ridho dari ibu Anda? Itu pertanyaannya.
Lebih penting Tuhan.
God is more important.
Sorry?
God.
Yes. Ask her, does she believe there is one God?
Apakah Anda percaya dengan satu Tuhan?
saya percaya.
Yes.
Does she believe Jesus is a messenger of God or is he God?
Apakah Anda percaya Yesus adalah Tuhan atau utusan Tuhan?
Yesus adalah utusan Tuhan.
Jesus is a messenger of God.
Masyaallah. Does she believe that Prophet Muhammad is the messenger of God, peace be upon him?
Apakah Anda percaya Nabi Muhammad adalah utusan Tuhan?
Ya, saya percaya.
Yes.
Kalau so the minimum requirement for anyone to be a Muslim is believe there's one God, believe Jesus is the messenger of God and Prophet Muhammad is the messenger of God. That means he's a Muslim.
Ya, berarti Anda seorang Muslim karena Anda percaya kepada satu Tuhan, percaya bahwa Yesus adalah utusan Tuhan dan Nabi Muhammad SAW adalah utusan Tuhan. Anda Islam, Anda Muslim.
That means he's a Muslim.
Ya.
Tell her.
Berarti Anda adalah seorang Muslim.
Ya.
Once if you believe in these two things, you enter into Islam, you enter the nursery. Then later on, slowly, you'll go into the first standard, second standard, third standard. But minimum requirement is these two things what she said.
Yeah. Syarat minimum untuk menjadi seorang Muslim hanya dua. Percaya kepada Tuhan yang satu, dan percaya bahwa Nabi Muhammad adalah utusan Tuhan, utusan Allah. Urusan lain nanti diurus belakangan.
That means she's already a Muslim.
Ya, berarti Anda adalah seorang Islam.
Would she like to say the same thing in Arabic? What she said
apakah
about one Allah?
Would she like to say in Arabic? Dalam bahasa Arab?
Bedanya, kamu ngomong aku percaya Tuhan, aku percaya bahwa Tuhan dalam bahasa Indonesia itu artinya cuma Mbak. Hanya kamu.
Enggak usah dijelaskan, Mbak, please. Mbak, enggak usah dijelaskan.
Babe, don't interfere, please.
Enggak usah dijelaskan, langsung aja yang bersangkutan.
Then Bukhari doing a very good job, inshallah he'll get sawab.
Alhamdulillah.
You have got a good Indonesian here. The way he's translating, I can understand he's doing a good job.
Yeah,
let us speak directly.
Yeah, langsung, Pak, jawab.
Would you like to say that in Arabic?
Apakah Anda bersedia menyatakan dalam bahasa Arab?
That there is one God and Prophet Muhammad is the messenger. Would you like to say in Arabic?
Hanya ada satu Tuhan dan Nabi Muhammad adalah utusan Tuhan.
Yeah.
Yes.
MashaAllah. Insyaallah I'll say in Arabic and after I say you can repeat it.
Insyaallah Dr. Naik akan menyatakan dalam bahasa Arab dan silakan diikuti.
Asyhadu
Allah
ilaha
illallah
wa asyhadu
anna
Muhammadan
abduhu
wa rasuluhu. Masyaallah. Can you repeat
dalam
in Indonesia?
Bahasa Indonesia. Ikuti saya. Saya bersaksi.
Bahwa tidak ada Tuhan.
Selain Allah. Dan Nabi Muhammad. Adalah utusannya. Dan pesuruhnya.
Takbir.
Allah Akbar.
Takbir.
Allah Akbar.
Takbir.
Allah Akbar.
That was for the sister to accept Islam and one more takbir for brother Bukhari. Takbir.
Allah Akbar.
Takbir.
Allah Akbar.
Takbir.
Allah Akbar.
Allah has made him the zariya for getting her hidayah.
Amen.
May Allah reward sister for accepting Islam. May Allah forgive your sin and may Allah reward brother Bukhari for doing a good translation.
Amen.
Zariya is very important. See.
Amen.
Brother.
Yes.
You are about to lose. Jazakallah shukran. And I pray, inshallah, see to it that you all get trained in this field of comparative religion. And may Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala give hidayah to all of us so that we can strive in spreading his message. I'd like to end this session. And inshallah, when time permits, we'll come again. Inshallah. Wa akhiru da'wana alhamdulillah rabbil alameen.